Meraki TV is proudly brought to you by George Focus of Focus Beyond, education for investing wisely. I'm Anna Savo, and this is Meraki TV, brought to you by George Focus of Focus Beyond, education for investing wisely. Tonight we talk to the comedians involved in the It's All Greek to Me comedy gala. Helen shows us a way to make kukia, or broad beans, actually yummy. Learn about the suyotes and the dance of Zalongo, plus all the glitz and goss with Stavroula. To get the night going though, we visit the Paniyiri in Brisbane, Australia's longest running Greek festival that celebrated 40 years this year, a jam-packed weekend which included Ambassador Effie, exhibitions, cooking demonstrations, lots of local celebrities, music, and of course food and more food. I'm here with Chris Kazonis, the chair of Paniyiri. Chris, welcome.
Welcome. Good to see you being here this year for the first time.
It's fantastic. I'm looking out. Oh my goodness, it's massive.
It's terrific. It's a really good start to the weekend.
I love the fact that we've got the main festival. We've also got the Greek club doing cooking demonstrations. You've got the church with church tours. It's really a full-on day.
Yeah, full-on. That's what we've planned. We've slowly got to that stage. When we started, we had an ecthesis in 1976. We graduated from half a day to one day to 2 days. And we also moved from the park only, we utilise the Greek club.
Tell us about this beautiful photographic exhibition that's happening here today.
Okay, today we have only 12 images from an exhibition that we previously displayed in 2012, celebrating 60 years of the Hellenic Photographic Society, Ελληνική Φωτογραφική Εταιρεία από την Αθήνα.
Tell us about this amazing display.
Okay, the Paniyiri originally started, and it was called the Ecthesis. And it started in 76, and our display starts with our first program and the events of the Paniyiri, of the ecthesis in that time.
These are the artifacts from the Meraki. These are replicas, of course, of the original, which were given to the Greek community of St. George by the Meraki Museum to be used in our ecthesis.
This is the booth for the R.D. Milne's Antiquities Museum at the University of Queensland. Professor Milne's started the museum when he was a classics professor, and the entire museum actually started from 3 and 4A, which were kept in his office. And gradually, as the collection got bigger under Professor Milne's leadership, the museum started to move around the university until it was in the place it is today.
The Greek Orthodox community of St. George, we've got a showcase here of all the functions that we do within our community. We've also got the islands of Greece that are represented here today, and they're just showcasing some of their specialties from their islands.
We have numerous Greek dancing groups. We've got a couple of the local schools who, like the Western State School, might have not a Greek kid dancing Greek in that Greek dancing group. The youth, if you look around the park, the volunteers on the park, all the associations that have volunteers, and if you have a good look, you see the number of young kids that are there, so passionate. They are more passionate than what a lot of the older ones were. They're proud to be Australian, but they love their Greek heritage. The park here, you'll see the music later on, you'll see that they might play Zorba the Greek 20 times, and 20 times, or everyone, all you have to know is he will get up, right, and want to do Zorba on the dance floor. They just love doing Greek music, Greek dancing. The Queensland government embraces. We were in 2009 voted one of the iconic 150 in Queensland, but there's a lot of work. I've got a great committee, the Greek community of St. George here. They do a wonderful job supporting it. I've got a real blend of young. I've got some 20-year-olds, 25-year-olds, 30-year-olds, not all oldies like myself.
What are you talking about? They're supposed to sit there and let the oldies do it all.
No. These kids are terrific. If they come up with 10 ideas, we'll probably take 7 of them.
Fantastic, Chris. Thank you so much for having us this year, and we can't wait to enjoy the rest of the day.
And I hope you come back next year, Anna.
Absolutely. Music and dance are integral to Greek culture. It has even become a way to mark history and pass on the stories so that they're not forgotten. One prime example is the dance of Zalongo. Here's more. Souli sits near Igoumenitsa in Ipiro, in northwestern Greece. In the middle of Greece's enslavement under Turkish rule, four villages, Souli, Kiafa, Araviko and Samoniva, established an autonomous confederacy dominating a large number of neighbouring villages in the remote mountainous terrain of Ipiro. There, they successfully resisted Ottoman rule. At its height, this confederacy is estimated to have comprised of up to 12,000 inhabitants in nearly 60 villages. There were many attempts to break this confederacy by the Turks, one particular highlight in 1731 when Haji Ahmed, Pasha of Ioannina, lost 8,000 men in his attempt, and the attempts were relentless. Integral to the Souliotes' success was their supplies, courtesy of Barga, but also Europe, who supplied weapons and ammunition. Seeing the Souliotes as a great instrument in weakening the Ottoman Empire, that is, until Britain needed the Ottoman Empire's help against Napoleon. Then the supplies stopped. This had a snowball effect, culminating in one of the major clans of the Souliotes, the Botsaris family, leaving Souli and parleying with Ali Pasha. The remaining Souliotes were no more than 2,000 and decided for Eleftheria y Thanatos, freedom or death. A very long siege ensued, with Ali Pasha even building castles in neighbouring villages to wait it out. The Souliotes stayed without food and ammunition and were set for an even longer fight until a trader, Belios Gusis, helped the Ottomans enter the village of Souli, and on December 7, 1803, they fought their last battle. Ali Pasha allowed them to survive, exiling them to the Ionian Islands. The Ottoman army, however, did not honour Ali Pasha's word and attacked the other Souliotes. In Zalongo, a group of women with their children fled the vicious attack up to the highest peak of the mountain, distancing themselves as far as possible from the conflict, but also trapping themselves. From up here, they could see what was happening below. The monastery where the men were holed up was set alight with the men still inside. The women knew there was no escape, and they also knew their capture and their children's capture would be brutal. They joined hands and danced their last dance, one by one throwing themselves and their children off the cliff while dancing and singing. A song has since been written in honour of the event. Στη στεριά δε ζει το ψάρι κι ούτε άνθος στην αμμωδιά κι οι σουλιώτισες δε ζούνε δίχως την ελευθεριά. Fish cannot live on the land, nor the flowers on the sand, and the women of Souli cannot live without freedom. It's time for an income breakthrough to free yourself from working for money, have your money work for you. George Focus of Focus Beyond will show you step by step how to generate income from the share market, irrespective of if it goes up or down. Access resources that do the hard work for you and devote no more than 60 minutes a month so you can enjoy financial freedom and time with family. To change your life forever, go to focusbeyond.com now. Irimia Home Care Services. It's so difficult asking for help.
Take the stress out and enjoy precious time because there's no place like home. Eremia.com.au. Digitalpress.com.au. Whether it's business or personal, your printing needs to be quick, easy, innovative, and of the highest quality. Mention Meraki TV for 20% off your first order. Digitalpress.com.au. IssyJewelry.com. Evil Eye Jewelry and unique fun pieces. Use the exclusive Meraki TV 20 discount code until June 30 for 20% off. IssyJewelry.com. Issy is you.
Hi guys, welcome back to Helen's Cuisina. Today, I'm going to show you how to eat broad beans. Now, what I mean by this is that when I was growing up, I hated them. My whole family hated them. And it was my mission in life to create a dish that everyone would love, and my family loves it. So guess what? Broad beans, no longer on the out, they're on the in. These particular broad beans are dried broad beans. They take 10 minutes to cook. That's all they take. A little bit difficult to get or a little bit challenging, but you can normally get them from any continental delicatessen. They're dry and they're small, and when they cook, they're so sweet and delicious, you're gonna love them. Now this broad bean dish is a vegetarian dish, so you can have it on its own with a bit of toast if you want, or a little bit of chopped tomato on the side. But today, I'm gonna cook it with a nice piece of lean fish as well. In my pot over here, I've got it on medium heat, and I have a half a cup of olive oil. Finely sliced red onion. Red onion's nice and sweet, and I love the color of it through the broad bean. And I've got some finely chopped up garlic, and I'm gonna pop that into my oil right now. So I've got my broad bean, and I've parboiled that for about 10 minutes. Really hot water, cook it for 10 minutes, strain it, and then it's ready to cook in our olive oil. Once again, you don't need to keep stirring it because the broad bean is actually now become quite soft. We just want it to simmer in there so that it's getting all that beautiful flavour from the onion and the garlic. You don't need to do anything. Just watch it and give it a lot of love. So my broad bean and my onion and my garlic has been cooking for about 5 minutes on really low heat. It's about this time that you want to add in about 2 tablespoons of lemon juice and our salt and pepper. So it's a little bit of multitasking here now, guys, because we're going to cook my fish while my broad beans are cooking in that beautiful olive oil and onion. We're letting the broad beans just simmer away until all of the liquid goes through it. But meantime, I'm going to cook my fish. I like to dip my fish in a little bit of flour and salt and pepper, and it doesn't take too long to cook. Literally 3 or 4 minutes on each side and you're done. So that's all it took, 20 minutes, parboiled my broad beans beforehand, tossed them in a bit of olive oil, a little bit of garlic, I fried up my fish, it's now ready to serve up. Just for a little bit of freshness, you can add some fresh rocket in there, or some coriander, or nothing at all, but I love that freshness in it.
The It's All Greek to Me comedy gala was an amazing effort started by George Kapiniaris to help Greeks in crisis. A night of laughs that would raise money for those most in need. Katerina Vrana, Angelo Tsarouchas, George Zakharopoulos and Tahir were amongst those who heeded the call. Here's Maria Khoklastou with more from that night.
How about Vasilis Garas? What a basket of muffins this guy is, huh? Na pite kiri tis matas ekini, pes tis pethenu. What did he say? When you see her, give her my best regards. Tell the I'm dying.
I asked you a question last year.
Yeah.
If there was anything you could do without fail, you said it would be to feed all the hungry children.
Absolutely.
And this is a big step towards that.
And we're doing it. So, I mean, it was just a coincidence. I did say that to you last year. And feed the hungry children, not discipline them. Because my daughter, my daughter's climbing my kefali like she's a little monkey.
Yeah, he's really funny.
What's your daddy's name?
Angelo Tsarouchas.
Sage is her middle name. Bravo, Kuklambo.
Mommy, I need an interview.
We're working to get some money together for an incredible organization, a charity in Greece called Diatrophie. And it is exactly what it says, Diatrephi. It feeds children, school children, whose families are doing it very, very hard in Greece during the GFC and the other crisis that has now unfolded in Greece and enveloped Greece. And last year alone, they served just under 1 million meals to kids who may not have had another meal that day. It's our job as Elines του Exoterikou to do what we can to help. And it's not just by going to Greece, which we all should, and spend some dollars there, because tourism is such a key industry in Greece, but it's also to buy Greek products whenever we can, spend more money to buy the Greek product. And so when the kids are coming out here with their uni degrees, but they can't get a job, etc., and they can come to Australia because there's some kind of family connection, etc., give them a job, help them out. Because they're our parents, you see. They're my dad who came out in 54 as a 22-year-old for a better life, because he knew that impoverished post-World War II Greece couldn't give him and his children that he didn't even have yet that life.
Okay, so Katerina, this isn't the first fundraiser you've actually done to support Greece. What else have you done?
It wasn't a fundraiser, it was a day of, in the UK, a day of trying to show that there's more to the crisis than what they see on TV. Like the whole culture behind the crisis. It was a whole day of Greek, Greek on the South Bank in London. It was called Greece is the Word, and it was all about poetry and acting and singing.
Oh, wow.
And music and comedy.
Tell us about last night. How much did we actually raise, or approximately, for Greece?
Well, look, this is how we're looking. I can't tell you exactly because, you know, we've still got another show to do here in Sydney, which we're very excited about. And there might be a few walk-ins. We might be a few cash sales at the door because we are dealing with pretty much a 90% Greek audience. So I think we're well over 20 grand. Of course, we've got expenses and what have you, and we'll be showing everyone all those expenses later on. But we've raised over 20 grand. Hopefully, we'll get to the 25 to 30 all grand.
Right. How about brutal, of course? What a club shoddy this guy is, huh? Sabato and club saya cena di Kiriaki Karamanta pire sta cronia. What did he say? Saturday he was crying. Sunday he was happy. You added 20 years to his life. Now all the shit's in the suitcase.
ValetSalons.com.au. Enjoy the ultimate Hollywood hair and body experience right here in Kogarah with Valet. Mention Meraki TV for a $25 hair treatment free with any service. ValetSalons.com.au.
DJ Crazy Con presents Greece 2016, the 17th installment in his iconic Greece CD series. 20 tracks of Greece's biggest artists: Bantilidis, Kiamos, Retos, Master Tempo, Salty, Dalidis, Vegas, Knockout, and many more. Plus a trademark super mix by superstar Greek Australian DJ producer Crazy Con. Get your hands on the hottest Greek CD this year, Greece 2016.
Whether it's Melbourne, Darwin, Queensland, something exotic, or just perfect Greece, call Mega Travel 9824 2427. The Many Faces of Hellenic Culture, a fascinating read by author Billy Kotsis, who takes us to the Greek colonies of the Mediterranean, Black Sea, Asia Minor, and the Middle East, available from Amazon and anywhere good Greek books are sold.
Greece are bringing their big guns down under for the first clash between the two nations in a decade. Socceroos versus Greece in two friendly games, June 4 at the ANZ Stadium, Sydney, and June 7 at the Etihad Stadium, Melbourne. A highly anticipated match. Kickoff will be at 8 p.m. Wedding proposals on stage are the trend at the moment. Last year at an Economopoulos show, and now at Yorgos Tsalikis's in Chicago, where a man popped the question to the woman of his dreams. Tsalikis was happy to be upstaged, even asking the girl, "What do you say?" Michalis Hadzianis, one of the most successful artists of the decade, could face prison time. He's been accused of money laundering in the period 2010-11 to the amount of 5 million euro. Once booted out of Greece's Next Top Model 2, and now a candidate for Miss USA, Greek-American Elena Laquatra has overcome tremendous adversity. The 24-year-old lost her hearing in both ears when she was four, and after several operations, she had a cochlear implant and has learnt once again to speak and listen. The beauty pageant is in Las Vegas this Sunday, June 5. A thriller in the skies as pilots of an American Boeing fell asleep while flying over the Aegean. Ground control were unable to communicate with the pilots for hours. When the aircraft entered the Greek airspace, two F-16s were sent to approach the Boeing over Santorini. The Greek fighter planes were seen by the flight attendants and passengers, who understood that something was wrong and woke the pilots. The legendary Eric Burdon was here recently with his band, Greek Sound Crew, and his beautiful wife, Greek lawyer Mariana Proestu. Together 18 years, she's also his manager. Eric Burdon, singer of rock band The Animals, who once sang with Otis Redding and jammed with Jimi Hendrix, is one of the greatest singers of all time. Have a listen. They left our shores, but Remos Aslanidou, Fureira and Martakis also left us with a great impression. One of the biggest shows to tour from Greece, it was a heartwarming tribute to Pandelidi. I will leave you here with this song in honour of his memory. I hope you've enjoyed the show tonight. A big thank you to all our guests and, of course, our major sponsor, George Focus of Focus Beyond Education, for investing wisely. Don't forget to check out our website during the week to find out more about us, and also to like us on Facebook. Follow us on Instagram and Twitter, and subscribe to us on YouTube to watch all our catch-up episodes. Tonight, I'm leaving you with highlights from the Brisbane Paniyiri, including the hilarious Greek Dancing with the Stars. Until next week, Bidia, be like it from me, Anna Savo.
There's a few things at play here, maybe a slight loss of points for the barefooting, I'm not sure if it's traditional or not, but that graceful seagull move, that's a six, an honourable six.
dance is better and she's in a wheelchair.
Meraki TV is proudly brought to you by George Focus of Focus Beyond, education for investing wisely.